हेलो, दिस इज स्वप्निल ममानी, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, महिला महाविद्यालय तासगांव। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ फंक्शंस बाय यूजिंग क्लासेस, ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड विद देयर स्कोप रेजोल्यूशन ऑपरेटर व्हिच वी लर्न in the all previous lectures. So let us see some examples with class, objects and with scope resolution operator. So as per the previous programs, design class, test. Before this, we have to include some library files here, which is hash include iostream.h and hash include conio.h. conio.h class test opening and closing. Take one variable like integer x to input the values. Take the public section for the void getx function. In this function we are going to take user input for the x value. Please type cout enter value for x. The x in this function x getting by user cin x. After entering the value by user, it sets to x. This is the getx function. Now for example, which is work on this x, write a function to check this x is even or odd. Write function to check given number is even or odd. It is a very simple example we already learned in the C language. Similar to like this, the logic is the same here. In each and every languages, there is no change in the logic of the programs, but there is a change only in the syntax. So, write a one function void check. Void check. Check EO. EO means even or odd. Void check EO. If x equal to, x mod 2 equal to 0, x mod 2 equal to 0, then this x value is even. So see out x in double quote is even number. It prints with the user input value for x is even number. Else, if x mod 2 is not equal to 0, then x is a odd number. So type cout x is odd number. semicolon. This is the check io function. Void main. Now, as per all C++ and C programs, type clear screen and getch functions. At the starting point, clear screen. At the end point, getch. Now call the above functions with their objects. So we have to first create one object, test obj. Obj dot get x. This function takes a value for x by user. Now call obj dot check io function. After calling this function, we will see how it works. Now check, is this okay or not? Success. Enter value for x, 34. 34 is a even number. Now check again for odd number, that is x 9. 9 is a odd number, so our output is a correct. Now, like a previous lecture, put the all function outside the class. How to declare this? Only declaration of the function inside the class, but the whole body of the function is outside the class. So put semicolon after declaring the function, and at the outside class where there is a function, use the scope resolution operator with the class name before the function name. So void test scope resolution getx. It means getx function is in the scope of test class. Now similar to the check io function, test scope resolution check io means check io is in the scope of test. Now check also, 5 is the odd number. So output is similar to the previous. Now write another one function to check the given number is prime or not. All these programs we are going to take in one single program, and with we are working with one single value, that is a x. So write a function, declare this function in the inside program, and write for body outside the program check prime. So void check prime. Also for this function you have to declare the scope resolution operator with their class name. So test scope resolution operator check prime. When the number is a prime or not, if that number is only divisible by one and that number only, that is that numbers is prime number. So write a code for that. For integer I equal to 1, I less than equal to x I plus plus. If number mod I, if number means x, x mod I, equal to 0, means if x is divisible by I, then increase the value of temporary plus plus. Now outside the for loop, if temporary equal to, that means if only number is divisible by 1 and that number only, then temporary should be only 2. Now write code for if temporary equal to 2, cout x is prime number, else that number is not prime. So type else cout x is not prime number, is not prime number. Now this is the function, call this function. Now comment for the previous called function, that is a check EO, and call check prime semicolon. Now check this by running this program, success. Enter value for x 11. 11 is the prime number, so our output is correct and our code is correctly working. Now again check for the not prime numbers, that is enter value for x, that is 22. 22 is not prime number because it divisible by multiple numbers, so that's why this is a not prime number. Now again in this way, this is the function. Now take another function for the calculate the factorial of this x value. Write a function to calculate factorial of given number. So like the previous function program, declare the function name void factorial. Factorial means the value, for example if that value is 5, the factorial of 5 is multiplication of 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. In between 1 to that number, so all the multiplications result, that is the factorial of that number. So how to check the factorial? Now take one variable integer fact equal to 1. This is the starting declaration for integer I equal to 1, I less than equal to x I plus plus. Now fact equal to fact into I, that means this is the total multiplications of 1 to that number. See out factorial of x insertion operator, extraction operator in double quote equal to factorial of x in double quote equal to फैक्ट, बिकॉज रिजल्ट इज इन द फैक्ट वेरिएबल. सो लाइक द प्रीवियस स्टेप्स, कॉमेंट कॉल द फंक्शंस विच इज अ चेक प्राइम एंड कॉल द फंक्शन फैक्टोरियल, ऑब्जेक्ट डॉट फैक्टोरियल. चेक द प्रोग्राम बाय रनिंग दिस प्रोग्राम. नाउ 5 फैक्टोरियल इज 120. इट्स ओके, इट्स ऑल डन. इन दिस वे आफ्टर सीइंग सम प्रोग्राम्स वी आर गोइंग टू नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. थैंक यू. To get the more videos of this series, please like, share and subscribe. And please do not forget to press the bell icon to view latest videos. Thank you.